Okay, in this video we will continue to study the peptic ulcer. So in this video we will study about the clinical features of peptic ulcer, especially duodenal ulcer and gastric ulcer. So we will see one by one what is the clinical features of duodenal ulcer and what are the clinical features of gastric ulcers. Regarding the clinical features of this peptic ulcer, that the point to be considered, that is, the clinical features of peptic ulcer is vary from complete absence of symptoms to life-threatening hemorrhage, and also it is very difficult to differentiate gastric ulcer and duodenal ulcer by symptom alone. And the next point to be considered, that is, that patient may be present with gastric ulcer symptoms but may be without any ulcer on investigation. So that is the point to be considered during the might be diagnosing the peptic ulcer, especially duodenal ulcer and gastric ulcer. Now let's see the first one, that is duodenal ulcer. Duodenal ulcer. Wait. So I'll change the color. We'll use red. Duodenal ulcer. Duodenal ulcer. Okay, just imagine this is a duodenal ulcer. So what point features that we have to see for this duodenal ulcer? The first one we have to see related to the incidence. So in incidence, duodenal ulcer is 4 times more common than gastric ulcer. So 4 times more than gastric ulcer. And the next one, regarding the age. So regarding the age, gastric ulcer, the age about 25 to 50 years old. Then the next point you have to see, that is related to the sex. So duodenal ulcer more common in male. Then what about the pain that present in the ulcer? So in duodenal ulcer, the pattern of the pain, that is pain. Then food relief pattern, pain food relief. And other points that we have to see, that is regarding vomiting. So in duodenal ulcer, there is no vomit, no vomit. And the other point, that is weight of the patient. So there is no loss of weight. Sorry, it's a mistake. Mean no weight loss, no weight loss. And regarding tenderness that might be that present in the ulcer, in the duodenal ulcer, so the tenderness will present deep tenderness in hypochondrium. Deep tenderness in hypochondrium. Then the next feature that is related to the scission. So duodenal ulcer is marked seasonal variations. Marked seasonal variation. And the next feature, that is site of the ulcer. Sorry. So the site of duodenal ulcer, that is in that is most common in first part of duodenum. First part of duodenum. Then related to melena, duodenal ulcer is common for melena. And related to hematemesis, it is uncommon. So hematemesis is uncommon. So sorry, this one is melena, okay? Melena. And the last one, that diet might be related to this duodenal ulcer. For diet, so no particular choice for diet. No particular choice. So this is about the features of duodenal ulcer.